الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما بك ومعرفة يا رب العالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Yesterday we finished the Battle of Badr, and the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he and his companions, they went back to Medina with all of these big things that they get and with 70 captives. Now, here there are a few things we need to learn, we need to understand. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he and his companion, they went back to Medina with huge benefits, let us say, or income. Some, they were fighting. Others, they were in Medina. And there were another group, there was one more group. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he already sent them to different, he already gave them different missions to do. That there were eight people, they were supposed to go and join Badr, but they didn't. But actually those eight, they had things to do. Like one of them, for example, Uthman ibn Affan. Uthman ibn Affan, he was the husband of Ruqayya. Who is Ruqayya? The daughter of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Uthman ibn Affan, he wanted to go, but Ruqayya was sick. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him to stay with Ruqayya. Other two, Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Sa'id ibn Zayd, those two, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he already sent them to another place to spy, you know, to be a spy, to check the caravan of the disbeliever. Another one, Abu Umama al-Ansari, he wanted to go, but his mother was sick. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told him, you stay with your mother, it is bigger jihad than coming with us. Another one, Al-Harith al-Muhatib, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sent him to another tribe for the discussion and negotiation for signing the agreement. And other two of the companions, they wanted to go, but one had broken arm and one had broken leg, so couldn't go. We already said that the big disbelievers in the Battle of Badr, the big disbelievers, they were dead. They were killed. And we already said, who killed Abu Jahl? Two kids. See, this big Abu Jahl was killed by two kids. Of course, when we read the hadith, there are many hadith, like for example, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, I killed Abu Jahl. Another one, Al-Harith, he said, I killed Abu Jahl. Those two kids, they said, we killed Abu Jahl. So who killed Abu Jahl then? All of them. How? First, the first one was Haritha. That one was one of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is telling the story. He said, I heard in Badr, in the battle, he said, I heard Muslims, they are saying, no one could reach Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl is killing people right and left, and no one could reach him. Because Abu Jahl was so strong. So he said, so I put Abu Jahl as my target. So I left everything and I just focused on Abu Jahl. Until I could reach him in a way that he couldn't reach me. That before his sword could reach me, I could reach him.
So
this is what he is saying. So I could cut his leg. And I saw his leg. This is what he is saying. And I saw his leg, how it was totally cut. And Abu Jahl fell down from his horse. So I went to kill him, but Ikrimah his son, the son of Abu Jahl, and Ikrimah later he became Muslim. So Ikrimah came, this is what Haritha is saying. So Ikrimah came and he cut my arm. So I was so tired and almost faint. So Ikrimah left me. He thought that I am dead. And my hand was not totally cut. Was still, you know, in the part of the bone maybe or whatever. Not yet totally cut. And then I moved. And I was fighting, seeing his hand is cut. And I went on fighting, and I was pulling my hand, my arm, because it was still a little bit stuck. He said, until finally I feel so tired to keep on pulling my hand, my arm. So I sit and I step over my arm and I cut it. And I kept on fighting. Actually, that Haritha, he passed away during the period of Uthman. He stayed alive like 15 years after this. So this is the first hadith. The hadith of the two boys, we already mentioned it, of the two boys, that they run after Abu Jahl, and both of them, they put the sword in his belly. someone who was killed in the war. This is something should be proud of.
他说呢，你为什么讲这种话呢？我是在战场上面杀死的，这是很骄傲光荣的事情。
See again, see what ignorance and arrogance, see what they do to people.
你可以知道他是多么的无知与傲慢。
Now, so this is one of the things. So now we know that all of them, they said that we killed them. Means all of them, they share in killing Abu Jahl.
就是说，这四个人都说是他们杀了Abu Jahl，所以他们四个人合手联合把他杀死的。
Now, the Prophet Muhammad SAW, he went back to Medina with 70 captives and a lot of things.
那先是带了70个俘虏和很多的战利品回到麦地那。
And here there is something we need to learn and we need to understand, because some people, they really don't understand this part. The companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were normal human beings.
先知的弟子们都是平凡人。
They were not angels.
他们不是天使。
And they were not those that they never make mistakes.
他们也不是都不会犯错。
They made mistakes.
他们也会犯错。
And this is normal.
这是很正常的。
Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He already said that if you don't make mistakes and ask me to forgive you, I will destroy you and to bring other people to make mistakes, then ask me to forgive them, then I will forgive them.
阿拉说呢，如果你们都不犯错的话呢，然后那我就会就是来，然后再来就是求饶的话，那我会把你们毁灭掉，我再创造另外一批人，他们会犯错，然后再给我求饶，让我再原谅他们。
So actually, there were two problems that time.
事实上，那时候有两个问题。
The first problem is what to do with the captives.
第一个问题就是说，要怎么处理这些俘虏。
The second problem is what to do with all of those things that we got in the war.
第二个是如何处理这些战利品。
The Prophet Muhammad SAW, we start with the captives. The Prophet Muhammad SAW, it is not mentioned in Quran what to do with the captives.
就在古兰经并没有教他要怎么样去对付这对待这些俘虏。
So the Prophet Muhammad SAW, he asked, what to do with the captives?
那先知就问说，要怎么样去对待这些俘虏呢？
He asked who? He asked the companions, but who was closer to him that time when he asked? Abu Bakr, Umar, and Ali.
那当时在他身边的是Abu Bakr, Umar, and Ali.
And of course others, they were there.
当然其他人也在场。
So the Prophet Muhammad SAW, he asked what to do with the captives.
那先知问说怎么处理这些俘虏。
Abu Bakr, he said, Ya Rasulallah, they are your family, they are your tribe, they are your people.
那Abu Bakr就说呢，阿拉的使者，他们是你的族人，他是你的家人。
So keep them, don't kill them, keep them, and then we see what will happen.
就是说我们把他留着，并把他们杀掉，看之后情况怎么样再说。
Umar ibn Khattab, what did he say?
Umar 怎么说呢？
Umar ibn Khattab, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I suggest that each one has a relative of those captives, give this captive to his relative, let him kill them.
就是说，就是每一个，each one of them，每一个俘虏，他们都有他们的亲戚，那就把这个俘虏给他们的亲戚，这样亲戚把他杀掉。
So we killed them all. This one, Umar ibn Khattab said, he said, Ya Rasulullah, they attack you, they betray you, they kick you out of Mecca, and they took all of our belongings. Let us kill them.
他就说：“阿拉的使者，他们就是攻击你，然后把你赶出去，然后你把你所有的财产都把你抢走，那我们就要把他杀掉。”
And Ali, he didn't say anything.
阿里什么话都没说。
Why? If Abu Bakr and Umar is talking, then who else should talk?
那如果阿布巴克跟欧玛都已经讲话了，那他还有谁会说？
No need.
就不需要说话。
Abu Bakr and Umar and the Prophet Muhammad SAW is there, then why do I have to talk?
既然他们三个都在场，那就轮不到我讲话了。 So
the Prophet Muhammad SAW, he looked at Abu Bakr. He said, Ya Abu Bakr, you act same as the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, same as the Prophet Isa alayhi salam.
那先知穆罕默德就跟阿布巴克说：“你就是跟那个伊布拉欣跟那个耶稣这两个先知一样的去做。”
And he looked at Umar radiallahu anhu. He said, "Ya Umar, you act same as the Prophet Nuh alayhi salam and same as the Prophet Musa alayhi salam."
然后就跟欧玛说呢：“你的行为就像是那个挪亚跟穆那个穆萨一样。”
See, to let, see the respect, to respect both of them.
他就是去尊重这两个人。
That none of you is wrong. Both of you are correct.
就是说你们两个的提议呢，都是对的。
Are we learning this today?
我们今天有没有跟人家学习这些风范？
Today, unfortunately, either you agree with me or you are captive. going to hell.
他就说呢，你要同意我说的话，不然的话你就要下地狱。
But the Prophet Muhammad Sallam is teaching us something else. Omar, what you said is similar to what Musa and Noah said. Abu Bakr, what you said is similar to what Ibrahim and Isa said.
那先知穆罕默德呢，就是很尊重这两个的意见，他就说呢，欧玛你的意见呢，不像是穆萨跟挪亚先知一样，那阿布巴克的意见不像是伊布拉罕跟耶稣先知一样。
But then what the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did?
后来先知怎么做呢
？He took the middle.
他采取了中间的路线。
He said, he looked at the captains.
他看着俘虏说。
He said, you are our captains. You will stay here until you obey the penalty, the fidya, to release you, or until you are killed. One of those two ways.
就是说呢，你们留在这里，如果有人支付这个赎金的话，你就可以走；那不然的话，就等到你们就是被杀掉为止。
This was the Prophet Muhammad said, because that time there was no ayah, there was no Quran about the captives.
因为那时候还没有古兰经的经文跟他讲说这个俘虏要怎么去对待他们。
But then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, after it is all finished, let us finish it first, and then we know what Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala said. So, they kept them, the Muslims, they kept those captives, and they said that you have to pay to release you, or you ask your people in Mecca to come and pay to release you.
就是说看你们自己要付钱呢，还是你要叫你们那个卖家那边亲戚的付钱来把你们赎回去。
And this is what happened.The disbelievers, al-mushrikeen there, they start to send people to pay for those captives, to release them. Now listen to this. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, either you pay, or if you don't have money, and your family doesn't have money, and no one could support you, then if you know how to read and write,You have to teach 10 kids of the Muslims in Medina. You have to teach 10 kids how to read and write, so we release you.
那先就说呢，若你们有些俘虏呢，你自己没有钱，你的亲戚也都没有钱把你赎回去的话，那你就要再教麦地那当地的居民的小孩子十个人，你要教他们，就是你若你识字的话，那你要教十个小孩子识字，然后教到好，你才可以回去。
So, see, the Prophet Muhammad SAW was making use of everything, and see how knowledge was important.Once those disbelievers, if they are ready, if they are able to teach, they will be released. See how the knowledge was important.
就是说呢，这些不信道的人，如果他识字的话，他去教这些小孩子，他就可以获得释放。所以由此可知，知识的重要性。
So they start to pay. Those al-mushrikeen, they start to pay, and their people start to come from Mecca to release them.
就是说，他们有些那些不信道的，就开始来付这些赎金，然后有些就过来就付赎金，把他们。
Now, let us just take few minutes just to talk about those who were released, some of those who were released. One of them was the husband of Zainab. Zainab, the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
那其中一个就是被一个俘虏的话，他是 Zainab 的丈夫。
The husband of the daughter of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. 哦，他就是那 Zainab 是那个先知穆罕默德的女儿。
That husband, Abu al-As ibn al-Rabi'a. Remember, we go back to Mecca. Remember, we said that the two daughters, Ruqayya and Umm Kulthum, they were wives of two brothers who were the kids of Abu Lahab, Utba and Utayba. We
之前有讲到说，先知穆罕默德两个女儿是嫁给Abu Lahab 的两个儿子。
Remember that story? And then Abu Lahab.He forced his two sons, or he asked his two sons to divorce the two daughters of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi
wasallam. 然后呢，阿布拉罕呢，他就是强迫他的两个儿子把先知穆罕默德两个女儿休掉。
And they did.
然后他们就真的把他休掉。
The third daughter was Zainab.
然后有第三，他那他第三个女儿叫 Zainab.
Zainab was the wife of Abu al-As ibn al-Rabi'a, another disbeliever.
那 Zainab 的丈夫呢是阿布。
Abu Lahab, he went to Abu al-As, he said, you have to divorce Zainab. You have to divorce the third daughter of the Prophet, of Muhammad. We want to let him suffer.
那 Abu Lahab 就跑去跟 Zainab 的丈夫讲说，你要把那个 Zainab 这个妻子把她休掉，因为我们要去将那个妻
to release her husband, but she sent with someone else, she sent her necklace. That necklace, it was so expensive, and it was a gift for her in her marriage day from Khadija, her mother.
那这个她没有亲自来这个麦地那，就是去把付钱把她的丈夫娶回去，而是她差遣人就是送她的这条项链过去麦地那。这条项链呢是她结婚的时候她的妈妈 Khadija 送给她的。
Because when the Prophet Muhammad SAW, when he moved from Mecca to Medina, Zainab didn't go with him because her husband was a disbeliever.
当先知穆罕默德从麦加要移民到麦地那的时候，她的这个女儿 Zainab 并没有跟她一起移过去，因为她的丈夫没有信仰伊斯兰。
So.She said that necklace. So the Prophet Muhammad SAW, he saw the necklace. He knows, of course, that this is the necklace of Khadija. So,
他就送了这个项链。然后先知穆罕默德一看到，就知道这个项链是他的妻子Khadija的。
So what did the Prophet Muhammad SAW do?
那先知穆罕默德怎么做呢？
He only said to the one who catched that Abu al-As, that al-As ibn Rabi'a. He only told that companion. He said, if you accept.Release him and return back this necklace to Zainab.
然后他就跟这个抓到这个 Zainab 的丈夫的这个人呢，这个弟子，他就跟他讲说，如果你愿意接受的话，你可不可以就是把他放回去，然后又把这个项链还给这个 Zainab?
See, it is not an order.
他并不是命令。
This is the leader, the prophet, the messenger, the king, but he was not giving orders. He was just asking.
所以他是一个领导人，但是他还是请求他，他并不是命令他。
So of course that companion, he said sure, and he released him. So the Prophet Muhammad SAW, he looked at the husband of Zainab, he said, I hope that when you arrive there, you let Zainab come to Medina.
然后呢，那个弟子就说，当然我接受。后来先知呢，就是把他放走之前呢，就跟这个 Zainab 丈夫说，我希望你回到麦加之后。
See, well, actually, according to Islam and according to the Arab morals that time, it was according to Islam, it was okay to kill him, to kill Abu al-As. He is a captive. He is a disbeliever.
根据伊斯兰的话呢，当时是可以直接把这个 Abu al-As 这个就是把他直接杀掉。
And according to the Arab tradition, when the husband is dead.Then the wife should go back to her family.
而且根据这个他们的一个习俗的话，如果说丈夫已经死的话，那这个妻子就要回到她的娘家去。
So actually, it was simple for the Prophet Muhammad SAW. It was simple. Just kill him, then he will receive his daughter.
所以先知穆罕默德其实他大可以就直接把他这个女婿把他杀掉，然后他女儿就可以回到他身边了。
But he didn't.
但他却没有这么做。
He released him, and for free, because he returned back the necklace. So he released him for free.And then he asked him, if you please, if it is possible, send Zainab to me.
他说他就免费的就把他送回去，就是把他放走，然后还跟他请求说，如果你同意的话，你会把 Zainab 让他来到麦地那跟我住。
And Abu al-As, although he was a disbeliever, he gave a promise. He said, yes, I will. So although he was a disbeliever, but he gave a promise. So he made his promise and he sent Zainab with a group of people to the Prophet Muhammad SAW.
那他这个女婿虽然说是一个不信道的人，但是他也是一个讲说话算话的人，所以说他就回去之后，那就是让他这个妻子这一两跟一群人就是移民到麦地那。
Anyway, later Abu al-As became Muslim later, and the Prophet Muhammad SAW he returned Zainab to him, so they remained together.
后来那个 Abu al-As 就是他这个女婿后来也成为穆斯林了，那他成穆斯林之后呢，他也让他的女儿Zainab再回去他的身边，就是再度成为。
So this was one of the captives. Another one was Suhail ibn Amr.
那另外一个俘虏就是苏海。
Do you remember Suhail ibn Amr? Suhail ibn Amr is the one who was making a lot of troubles to the Prophet Muhammad SAW. The one who was very good at talking.
苏海他是一个能言善道的，他给先知穆罕默德找了很多麻烦。
And Suhail ibn Amr is the one who later we will see in Al-Hudaybiyah, who later will say a lot of bad things to the Prophet Muhammad SAW.
那苏海这个人，就之后在讲Hudaybiyah这个。
And actually, Suhail ibn Amr, he was very good at talking, and he used to use his way of talking, that, you know, the good thing he has, which is the way of talking, he used to use it against the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
那时候他因为他很会讲话，他常常就是讲一些话来对付先知马默德。
And Umar ibn al-Khattab, when he saw Suhail, he said, Ya Rasulallah, give him to me, give this Suhail to me. I want to cut his tongue so he will not be able to say any bad word about you anymore.
Umar 看到这个 Suhail 就说呢，哎，就是把他交给我，我要把他的舌头剪掉，让他就不会再乱讲话。
What did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam say?
那先知马默德怎么回答呢？
He said, No need.
他说不用。
One day, Suhail will say something good.Will say something to help Islam.
他说有一天的时候，他会说一些好话来帮助到伊斯兰。
And it happened when.
后来真的发生了。
Suhail ibn Amr later he became a Muslim.
苏海后来成为穆斯林。
And when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, there were some people they left Islam in Mecca.
那当孙仲威的归真之后呢，麦加有一些穆斯林呢，就是离开了，就是出教了。
When I say they left Islam, they didn't say that we disbelieve in Allah anymore. No.They only said one thing. They said we will not pay zakat.
就是说，我们所谓的他出教的话，并不是他们不信仰阿拉，而是他们说我们要付天课。
Only they refused to pay zakat. They said that the zakat was to the prophet. The prophet passed away. Don't need to pay zakat anymore.
他们说这个天课是要交给先知的，先知未知的，他就不用再交了。
So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he prepared the army to go and fight, attack them because they are what we call them the.That they left Islam.
那阿布巴克呢，就派遣了一个军队要去攻打这一群穆斯林啊，因为他们就是违背了这个伊斯兰。
But then Suhail ibn Amr, there, he stand up in front of all of them and he talked, and actually he said very good words that he let them all accept to pay zakah and to remain as they are.
那Suhail呢，他当时就在麦加那边去跟这一群人就是做了一番的演讲。
Another one was the captive Al-Walid ibn Al-Walid, the brother of Khalid ibn Al-Walid.
就是另外一个俘虏的，就是瓦里。
Of course, Khalid ibn Al-Walid that time was not yet Muslim.
就是 Khalid ibn Al-Walid 他原本不是穆斯林。
So Khalid, he went to pay for his brother Al-Walid, and he took him, he and his brother, he went to pay for Al-Walid who was captured, and they released him and went back to Mecca.
那这个瓦利德他就是有两个兄弟的，就去那边，然后付了赎金，然后把他带回去麦加。
When they released him, when they arrived to Mecca, Al-Walid, he said, "Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah." He said, "I'm a Muslim."
就是说，当他被释放，就是回到麦加的时候，他一抵达麦加呢，他就说他是穆斯林，他就念了做证词。
So Khalid al-Walid asked him, he said, "Why didn't you say this in Medina? We would save this money."
那这个 Khalid 呢，就是他的哥哥呢，就说你为什么在麦地那时候不要讲这句话？这样我就不用。
Al-Walid said, he said, I didn't want to say it there. I don't want them to think that I said it to save this money.
他就说呢，我不要在那时候说，因为我不要让他们以为说我只是为了省钱，所以才说我从信教。
And he left Mecca, went back to Medina.
然后他说完之后，他就离开麦加，然后回到麦地那去。
And actually later, once the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked Al-Walid, he asked him, what did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell him? He told him,Ya Walid, someone like Khalid, for sure he knows what is Islam.
就是后来再问，把那个瓦利说，先生，我在跟你讲什么呢？那他就说，先生跟我说呢，像Khalid这个人，他一定知道伊斯兰。
So Al-Walid, he said, Ya Rasulallah, he will come soon, he will become Muslim.
那那个瓦利就说，阿拉的使者啊，他会很快就成为穆斯林，他就会来。
And later, Khalid ibn Walid, he became Muslim, and he became Saifullah ibn Mas'ud.The sword of Allah.
那后来瓦利真的，哈雷的瓦利，他后来真的成为穆斯林，而且他成为伊斯兰的剑。
One of the captives was Wahab ibn Umayr.
其中的一个俘虏就是 Wahab.
Wahab doesn't have a story. Umayr, his father, has a story. What is the story of Umayr? Umayr, he was in Mecca, and he was talking to Safwan.Safwan ibn Umayyah, one of the big leaders in Mecca who was so rich. Yeah, no, the name's no problem. Umayyah was the father of one of the captives.
Umayyah, 他是其中的一个俘虏的父亲。
He was talking to another disbeliever who was rich.
他跟另外一个很有钱的不信道人讲。
He was saying, if I didn't have debt,
他说如果我没有债务的话
I would go to Medina and cut the head of Muhammad.
我就去麦地那，然后把那个穆罕默德的头砍掉。
So Safwan ibn Umayyah, that rich person, he said, I will pay your debt.
那 Safwan 呢，这个有钱的人，他就说呢，我会把你的债务还清。
And you go and kill Muhammad.
那你去把穆罕默德的头砍掉。
So Umayyah, he said, okay, and he went to Medina to meet the Prophet and to kill him.
那 Umayyah 他就跑到麦地那要去杀先知穆罕默德。
When he arrived, and he had the sword. And this was normal that they used to carry the sword most of the time. When he arrived, so Umar ibn Khattab, he saw him. So Umar ibn Khattab didn't kill him, but what he did, he just catch him. You know how big Umar was. He just catch him and bring him to the Prophet Muhammad. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, I found this person outside. Shall I kill him?
他说：“阿拉的使者，我在外面看到这个人，我应该把他杀掉吗？”
So the Prophet Muhammad said, "No, leave him."
那先知说：“不用了，放掉。”
So he left him.
他就把他放掉。
Then the Prophet Muhammad said, "He told Umar, leave, leave, go."
那先知就跟 Umar 说：“你走。”
But Umar ibn Khattab didn't want to go. He said, "Ya Rasulullah, he has the sword."
那 Umar 就说呢：“我不要走，因为这个人身上有带剑。”
So the Prophet Muhammad said, "Told Umar, Khattab, he said, leave." So he left. Then the Prophet Muhammad started to talk to Umayyah. He said, Why did you come to Medina? He said, I just come to check if I can release my son. He said, And how about this sword you have? He said, It's only a sword. It didn't help us in battle. Then the Prophet Muhammad put it to him and said, I don't think that you are telling me the truth. He said, It is the truth. He just wanted to make sure that no one around him, so he can kill the Prophet Muhammad. Then the Prophet Muhammad asked him, he said, And how about the meeting between you and Safwan? That Safwan said that he would pay the debt for you and you would come. So Umayyah he said, no one knows this, only me and Safwan. As you could know this, then for sure you are the Prophet. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad
Rasulullah.
He became Muslim. He went back to Mecca. He told people in Mecca that he is Muslim and he came back to Medina. Now, one of the captives was Al-Abbas. Al-Abbas, the uncle of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi
wasallam.
Yes, the uncle of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't say, release my uncle. Al-Abbas was rich. And actually, Al-Abbas didn't want to go to war. But Abu Lahab and Abu Jahl, they kept on telling him, you are a coward, and then, you know, for Arabs that time, kill him and don't say he is coward, you know. To say you are a coward, this is very big swearing. So, He went with them, so he was a captive there. And then they want, you know, they to release him. He and Aqil. Aqil is the cousin of the Prophet Muhammad, but not the son of Al-Abbas. Aqil is the son of Abu Talib. It means that he is the brother of Ali. So Al-Abbas, he paid for himself and for his cousin. And Al-Abbas was talking to the Prophet Muhammad and he was saying that, I don't have money. If I did this, I will be, you know, bankrupt. Then the Prophet Muhammad said, no, you already told your wife before you leave. You already told her that this place, this place. this is a miracle for the prophets, for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or for other messengers. But such kind of things may happen today and may happen anytime until the day of judgment with special people.
对这个先知使者来讲，这是神迹，但是也有可能发生在先知以后的人，也是有可能的。So
don't think that this is something big.
所以不要以为这是什么很多么重大的事情。
This is something may happen, depends on the relation between the person and Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
就是说呢，看这个人跟阿拉金的关系，那是有可能发生的。
من تعرف على الله بسننه المفروضة تعرف الله عليه بسننه الخارقة. What is the meaning of this? This is in fiqh. The one who knows Allah, the one who follows the rules of Allah, the one who is obeying Allah according to what Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is ordering us to do. The one who does this, when he does it in the correct way, then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will give him the over, the abnormal things.
一个人如果他服从阿拉信仰，阿拉遵守阿拉所教他做的事情的话，那么阿拉会给他一些更超乎的一些奖赏，一些东西。
Like for example, when you pray in the correct way.
比方说呢，礼拜的方式很正确。
What I mean by correct way, we mentioned it many times. What I mean by correct way is not that facing the qibla and already had the ablution and, you know, standing in this way and sitting in this way and bowing in this way. This is one part of praying. But the real...
我们之前有讲过呢，所谓的正确的一个礼拜，不是说你就是面对着礼拜的方向，然后你有小静，然后你就是礼拜的动作都正确，就叫正确的礼拜，这是一个方面。那还有另外一个方面。
But the real part of praying is the praying that when you finish it, let us make it in this way. When you finish it, you feel that you really did the thing that makes you relax, satisfied, and feel comfortable.
那真正的重点就是说，在你礼完拜之后呢，你会觉得说你今天礼完之后呢，你身心舒畅，那你觉得非常的愉快。
Do we feel so when we finish praying?
我们礼拜完有这种感觉吗？
Or we feel that, oof, alhamdulillah, we finished praying, okay, Allah, let us sleep.
还是你完拜就说，哦，终于你完拜了，好，太好了。
How do we feel?
就看了你完拜的当下的感受是怎么样。
See, you know the answer.
就你自己知道这种感觉。
If you feel that, you know, I have to pray, anyway, what to do, it's a duty, I have to pray. Let me just finish it first, let me finish praying first, then I will be relaxed.
就是说呢，反正就一定要礼拜啊，这是本分啊。那所以赶快把它礼完，那礼完之后我就会放松了。
Is it this or I want to relax so let me pray? let us say that someone who has this relation with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he himself, he knows that he is with Allah, Allah is with him. Now when this...
他跟阿拉已经有保持非常紧密的一个关系，他知道他与阿拉同在，阿拉与他同在。
Now when someone comes to this person and offer him billions, will he care?
一个人来给他好几十亿的钱，他还会很在乎吗？
He will not care. Why? Because he knows that it is useless. I'm just waiting. I'm counting the minutes when I will meet Allah Tabaraka wa Taala personally.
因为他觉得这个已经不重要了，因为他只是在计算什么时候才可以单独跟阿拉在一起。
Now, another part. When this person got the power from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala to fly, will this make any changes to him? Nothing. You've got the point that when you are related, when your relation with Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is the correct relation, then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, he will give you those things. He will give you those things. For example, I will look at Brother Ali, then I will tell him what he ate yesterday, and what he ate today, and what he did during the day, and who called him, and who told him this and that, and what they were talking at home, and. But then, does this mean anything to me? No. Why? Because do I want him to worship me? No. Do I want him to respect me? I don't care. Do I need anything from him? I don't care. Why? Because I am with Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. That is the relation that I care.
那我们跟阿拉之间已经建立一个非常正确、非常好的一个关系的话，那就算说我已经有具备一些超能力，我都可以知道你今天发生什么事情，我可以一一的到来。但是这样的能力对我来讲有什么的关系呢？因为我并不在乎，也不需要任何人来崇拜我，因为我真正在乎的是我跟阿拉之间是非常管道是非常畅通的。
But now listen to this carefully. Al-Abbas, when he told the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam this, and the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, he replied him, he told him that you kept the money here and there and there. Then what did Al-Abbas say? Al-Abbas, he said, I didn't want to come for fighting, so why do I have to pay the money? Listen to this. This is something we need to keep it in mind these days. We need to keep it in mind always with us. What did the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ say? This is the Prophet, the Messenger of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. What did he say? He looked at Al-Abbas. He said, we care what we see. We saw you in the battlefield. We don't know what is in your heart.
先知穆罕默德他就跟他讲说呢，我们在乎的是眼见为凭。我看到你就上战场来打我们，我们在乎你的举意，你的原本的意图是什么？
This is the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi
Wasallam. 这是先知穆罕默德所说的话。
The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that he is receiving the revealing from Allah Tabaraka wa Taala. The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that Allah Tabaraka wa Taala sent him Jibril to tell him things. It was so easy for Allah Tabaraka wa Taala to tell the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam what is in the heart of Al-Abbas.
先知穆罕默德他是阿拉的使者，他那阿拉大可以派遣那个加百列天使告诉先知穆罕默德所有的一切，别人心里在想什么。但是先知穆罕默德他却没有这么做。
Even in one hadith, in one seerah book, they say that Al-Abbas said, "Why do we have to pay the money? And we are Muslims."
那事实上有在另外一个历史的记载说，阿巴斯曾经讲说呢，我是穆斯林，为什么还要付赎金？
Because remember, I told you that Al-Abbas in Mecca, he was a Muslim, but he was hiding. But we don't know, was this before Badr or after Badr?
就我们这里有讲到说，阿巴斯他在穆斯林，他算是一个穆斯林的卧底。那我们不晓得说，在这个白尔战之前还是之后，他才成为穆斯林。
But still, the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what did he say? He said, "We are acting with you. We are dealing with you according to what we see from you. We saw you in the battlefield fighting." We don't know what is in your heart.
那先知穆罕默德说呢，我们看到你的是你的行为，我看到你有上战场来杀人的话，那我在乎你心里在想什么。
Today, many of us, we are dealing with each other according to what is in your heart, according to what I think that it is in your heart.
那反观我们现在呢，我们在彼此对待的时候，我们都会根据什么？根据我心里面认为你心里在想什么。
Who are you to know what is in my heart?
就是说呢，你怎么会知道我心里在想什么？
How can you know what is in my heart?
你怎么知道我心里在想什么？
in Ghazwat Mu'tah, in one of the battles. When I told you this before, when the companion came to the Prophet Muhammad, he said, Ya Rasulullah, one disbeliever. He said, La ilaha illallah, and I killed him. The Prophet Muhammad, he became so angry. Of course, that companion he knew, he could see that the Prophet Muhammad was angry. So he told him the story. He said, Ya Rasulallah, I was fighting. Then I put my sword on his neck to cut his head. So he said, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Listen, so I released him. This is what the companion is saying. So I released him. Once I released him, he took his sword again and tried to kill me. So again, I was fighting, and then again I put the sword on his neck. So again he said, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. So I released him. After I released him, he took his sword and he came to attack. You know, he was trying to fight. So I put the sword on his neck. He said, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. I cut his head. What did the Prophet Muhammad say?
那先生问我的怎么说呢?
He said, and what you did with La ilaha illallah? Someone is saying, La ilaha illallah, you killed him, how come? He said, Ya Rasulallah, ma qalaha illa indama ra'a bariqa sayf. He said this when he saw the sword over his neck. So the Prophet Muhammad asked him, did you open his heart and see? See? Are we learning from the Prophet Muhammad? We are not learning from him. Maybe we hear something about him, but then we do what we want to do. For personal things, we attack each other. For personal things, we say, this is hypocrite, this is good, this is bad, this is kafir, this is fasiq, this is in hell. While the Prophet Muhammad was so angry from someone who was so clear according to the story, so clear that he is not Muslim, but he said, La ilaha illallah, don't kill him. When someone does the haram thing so clearly in front of everybody, then this is something. But when you assume by yourself, then keep it to yourself. So this is Al-Abbas. Now, here, although the Prophet Muhammad SAW, he let Al-Abbas to pay the money. He let Aqid to pay the money. He let others to pay the money. But at the same time, the Prophet Muhammad SAW, he released a lot of these believers' captives when he was sure that they are poor. Because Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He mentioned this in Quran. This is an order in Quran. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ شُهَدَاءَ لِلَّهِ وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ الْأَقْرَبِينَ. This is an order from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. You who believe means if you believe, listen. If you don't believe, don't listen. You have to be equal, you have to be fair, you have to be just. You have to be a witness. When you see something wrong, you have to be a witness. Don't say, this is not my business. Listen. physical. Even if this witness is against yourself.
就算说你要去指证，就做这个证人，会影响到你自己的利益的话，你还是要出来作证。
Wal aqrabin and your relatives.
那或者说危害到你的亲戚的话，你还是要公证。
This is order from Allah Tabaraka
wa Taala. 这是阿拉的命令。
Today are we following this ayah? This is in chapter 4, by the way. Today are we following this ayah?
这是第四章，但是我们今天有在遵守这一章规定。
Or today we see someone who is doing bad things to Islam, who is hurting Islam, who is attacking Islam, but he is my cousin, he is my brother, he is my relative. Okay, let him do it, no problem. Close your eye and don't see it.
那今天如果说有一个人他很明目张胆的在攻击伊斯兰，在伤害这个伊斯兰的社群的话。但是因为他是我的表哥啊、表弟啊，那我想说啊，最后没看到，就不管他。
The one who does this, according to this ayah, not according to what I say, according to this ayah, Allah Tabaraka wa Taala start the ayah by saying what? يا أيها الذين آمنوا, those who believe. So if you consider yourself as a believer and you don't follow this ayah, then stop talking, don't cheat others. You are not a believer.
如果说呢，你这样做的话呢，你去包庇自己人的话呢，那根据这张古兰。经文的那个一开始，阿拉就讲说那些信道的人，那些信仰的人，那你要听从。那所以说你没有听从的话呢，那表示你是个不信道的人。
See how far away from Islam are we?
就是说我们可以知道自己跟伊斯兰距离有多么遥远。
People they are ready to hurt each other for some reason. They are ready to hurt each other for some reason. They are ready to tell lies. They are ready to say fake statements. They are ready fake witness.They are ready to hurt others. Why? He is my cousin.
就是说，有些人呢，就是为了钱，或者是为了他的亲戚，他不惜呢，就是去伤害人家，或者去说谎，或者去做伪证。
Or he is my brother, or he is my father, or he is my son. Who is more important, he or Allah?
就是说，他是我的爸爸，他是我的表哥啊，谁比较重要？是他比较重要，还是阿拉比较重要
？If we don't correct ourselves.Then we have to be careful. Either Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He Himself correct us here, which is so hard. Or He let us pay up, which is harder.
如果我们现在立刻纠正自己的行为的话，要么阿拉他自己亲自出手的话，在这里我们会受到的这个结果呢，是非常的痛苦的。那不然的话，就是在后续的话呢，在审判那这时候的那个代价呢是更高的。
Muslim.This is what I start by saying it at the beginning. Do not think that the companions, they were angels. They were not angels.
不要以为做先知的弟子们都是天使，他们不是天使。
They did mistakes.
他们也犯过错。
All of us, we make mistakes.
我们大家都会犯错。
But also at the same time, it is not so important that you make a mistake or you don't make a mistake. The important thing is, do you admit? Do you regret? Do you repent? Do you correct?
重点不是说这个人会不会犯错，重点是说你犯错之后，你会不会承认，然后呢去知过能改，然后去弥补你所造成的一些损失那个伤害。
This is the important thing.
这才重要。
The companions of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, when they saw all of this money, all of these belongings, all of those food and this and that in front of them, then Shaytan started to work.
当那先知的弟子们看到那么多的那个战利品的时候呢，那个撒旦就开始做工了。
8 people, they didn't fight with you. They didn't join the war with you. Why would they take the money?
那他就撒旦就开始出啊，有8个人没有跟你们上战场啊，为什么他跟你们一起分这些战利品呢？
Why this one will take more than this? Why that one will take more than this?
为什么这个拿的比较多呢？为什么那个拿的比较少呢？
And those, they are coming from Mecca. And those, you are Al-Aqsa, you are Al-Muhajirin. So, those are your money, for Al-Muhajirin. Shaytan is talking, those are your money, you shouldn't share.With Al-Ansar.
然后就说呢，哎，你们是麦地那的，然后你们这是麦加的，然后跟麦地那说，哎，你们是这些麦地那的居民，你们现在拿的是战利品，是你们就是在麦加那边被人家夺走的，这些钱是你们的呢，为什么要分给麦地那的人
？And Shaytan is talking to Al-Ansar. They live in your houses. They live in your place. Why they should take it? You are offering everything to them. They shouldn't take anything.
然后水战呢又跟那个麦地那的居民说，你看他们来这里又。
So Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He revealed Quran for this.
So Allah is for this.
Yes, Alun, asking you, they are arguing. This is the ayah. They are arguing about al-anfal. Al-anfal is the income, you know, all this income from the war. They are asking you, Muhammad, about this. What are you going to do with this? How are you going to give it? Are you going to give them more? Are you going to give us less? This is how they were asking the Prophet Muhammad. They were not asking that time. Some of them, they were not asking to know. No, they were asking to argue. Argue who? The Prophet Muhammad.
They were asking
Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he answered from Quran. In Quran. يسألونك عن الأنفال. They're asking you about this. قل you Muhammad tell them. قل الأنفال لله ورسول. Tell them this is to Allah and to His Messenger. It is not your business. He give it to anyone he wants or he take it all for him.
跟他說呢,
see how Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala solved the problem. See how He teach us how to solve the problem.
所以阿拉就教导我们要怎么去解这个问题。قل الأنفال لله والرسول.
This, all of this you see in front of us belongs to Allah and to me. The Prophet Muhammad
sallallahu
alaihi wasallam.
就是说你原先这一切的战利品是属于阿拉，也是他又属于我，就是乌罕沃德的。不要为了钱在那边争执不休。不要为了那一些财产在那边吵架。不要敬畏阿拉，要赶快醒一醒。
When you wake up, what you do, وَأَصْلِحُوا ذَاتَ بَيْنِكُمْ and solve those problems, it means, and forget about those problems between each other.
那醒来吧，然后不要再为这些事情在互相，为了钱在那边争执。
In our language today, don't lose your belief for some money.
那用我们今天白话来讲的话，就不要为了一些小钱把你的信仰给赔掉。
In our language today, don't lose the hereafter for this life.
用我们现在白话来讲的话呢，就是不要为了今生而失去了后世。
This is the meaning of فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَصْلِحُوا ذَاتَ بَيْنِكُمْ وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ and obey Allah and His Messenger.
你要服从阿拉还有他的使者。
When, why, for what? إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ again, if you are believers.
就是说，如果你是真正的信士的话，你就要这么做。
So what does it mean? It means, if you don't do this and this and this, according to the ayah, remember we said before, when we want to understand the ayah in a better way, if we find that it is difficult, just twist it, make it upside down. Read it from, you know, in the opposite way, you will understand it. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is saying, this belong to Allah, belong to Muhammad. So obey, so fear Allah. And do not lose this, do not lose the hereafter for this. Do not lose the hereafter for this and obey Allah and obey the Prophet if you are believers.
就是说呢，这些财产是阿拉和穆罕默德的。那你们要敬畏阿拉。那就是说你要你不要为了今生而失去了后世，你要服从阿拉，要服从穆罕默德。如果你是真正的信使的话。
We take it in another way.
那如果反过来讲的话呢？
So it means if you don't obey Allah, you don't obey the Messenger, you don't fear Allah, you fight here, you lose the hereafter for this life. If you are doing this, then you are not believing. This is Quran. So let us check. Today, do we fear Allah? Do we obey Allah? Do we obey the Prophet
Muhammad?
And do we make sure, are we doing our best to keep things between us in a good way?
我们有没有尽自己最大的能力，让我们彼此之间能够就是好好的去相处？
If the answer is yes, if the answer for all of us is yes, then we are Mu'mini believers. But if the answer is no, then we know who we are.
那如果答案是肯定的话，那我们就是活在驾驶的故事里。那如果答案是否定的话，那我们自己知道是什么样的人。
So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he took everything when he found that they are fighting, he took everything and then he shared, he gave all of them, he gave them equal.
那当先知穆罕默德看到大家为了这个钱那边争论不休的话，他就把钱全部都收回来，然后呢，他就平均分配，每个人都得到一份。
And all of them, they accept.
所以大家全部都接受了。
Of course, here there is something. All of them they accept, but all of them they regret. They said, all of them they were so sad. They said, Allah revealed Quran to shout us.
看他们大家当然会接受先知穆罕默德最后的那个裁决，可是他们呢也都非常的懊悔，就说阿拉就是为了我们的这个争执，他降下古兰经来骂我们，来责备我们。
They start to blame themselves. They start to regret. They start to repent. They start to ask Allah to forgive them. Why?Because Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala revealed Quran to shout them, to blame them. At the same time, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala revealed another ayah related to what? Related to the captives. Remember, we said that two problems. One is the captive, one is the income. So regarding the captive, after they finish it, they make big money. They make like 20,000 dirham. Like you can say like 20 million maybe today. They make big money.
就是说他们就是这个俘虏呢，就是释放俘虏拿这个赎金的收入呢，大概有20,000的这个dirham。
This is from selling the captive, from releasing the captive.
就是这个赎金。
So Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, after it is done, after it is finished, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala revealed Quran. مَا كَانَ لِبَنِ نَبِيٍّ أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُ أَسْرَى فِي الْأَرْضِ حَتَّى يُخْلَى. So here, this is the point. حَتَّى أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُ أَسْرَى حَتَّى يُخْلَى فِي الْأَرْضِ. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is saying that the Prophet shouldn't get those captives to make money from them.
那这个这件事情全部处理完之后，阿拉降这个古兰经说的这个先知呢，不应该用释放这个俘虏来赚钱。
Turiduna arad al-dunya, you want something for this dunya, you want to collect money for this dunya. Wallahu yuridu al-akhirah, and Allah wants you to think of the hereafter.
就说你想要为今生来收取更多的一个金钱吗？财富吗？他说阿拉法师说的，就是后世是更重要的。
This ayah is blaming who?
那这一节经文是在责怪谁？
If we take it literally, it is blaming who?
若从字面上来讲，他在责怪谁？
It is blaming the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu
alaihi wasallam. 这一节经文是在责怪先知穆罕默德。
Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was the one who said that you will pay money to be released.
因为先知穆罕默德这是他的决定，他说呢，你要付这个赎金，我才把俘虏放回释放。
Did he hide it?
那先知穆罕默德他有就是这些责怪他的经文，他有把他偷偷藏起来不要给大家看吗？
Did he hide this ayah? He did.
他有没有把这些经文就是藏起来不要给大家看？他也是公布给大家看。
Why? Because he is Rasulullah. Because he is the messenger of Allah.
因为他是阿拉的使者。
And to teach us a lesson.
他也是要给我们教导我们。
What is this lesson? When there is something, when the truth.Is against you. Even if it is against you, is this the truth? Yes. Be brave. Stand up and say it.
若当这个事实哈呈现在眼前是不利于你的时候呢，那你还是要勇敢的站出来去承认去接受。
And not only say it. This is Quran. This is Quran. Until the day of judgment, forever we are reading this ayah.
那你要知道这是古兰经的，从当时一直到世界末日呢，每个人就是都会读到这些经文。
عبس وتولى أن جاءه الأعمى وما يدريك لعله يزكى أو يذكر فتنفعه الذكرى. This is one chapter in Quran. Half of the chapter is blaming the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
就是有这节经文呢，它是 half of the chapter.
Half of the chapter is blaming.
就是这一章的一半的经文呢，全部都是在责怪先知穆罕默德。
The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting with big disbelievers, big people, big tribes.
先知穆罕默德跟一群不信道的一群那个外族的人坐在一起。
And he was trying to convince them to become Muslim.
他试着要去说服他们成为穆斯林。
Then Abdullah ibn Kulthum, no ibn Kulthum, or anyway, one of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad who was blind, he came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's blind. He didn't know.That he is sitting with those big people. He came and said, Ya Rasulullah, I have some questions about Islam.
那就有一个弟子呢，他是眼睛是盲，他是个盲人，他不知道说先知跟一群外人就坐在那边一起讲道，所以他就跑过来，他就走过来跟先知说呢，阿拉的使者，我有问题要请教你。
And the Prophet Muhammad was busy and focusing on talking to those big people. Those big people, if they became Muslims, they were the leaders of big tribes. If they became Muslim, the whole tribe would become Muslim.
那先知穆罕默德他现在很忙，他正在跟一群那个一些外族的一些领导人、一些酋长讲话。如果这些酋长接受的话，那么整族全部都会成为穆斯林，那是很大的一件事情。
So the Prophet Muhammad just told, he told Abdullah, he told him, I'm busy, not now, later. He just told him in this way.
他就跟这个 Abdullah 这个盲人说，哎，我现在在忙，我不要跟你讲话，你先走开。
And he left.That person he left.
那这个盲人就走了。
Did Allah Tabaraka wa Taala let it go?
那阿拉有就不管他了吗？就是、
no.
没有。
عبس وتولى. Allah Tabaraka wa Taala says عبس. That the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam he made this وتولى and he turned his he gave him his back. And جاءه الأعمى when the blind person came to him.
就先这个经文就讲说，在这个盲人来的时候，先知穆罕默德就皱起他的眉头，这样对他。
وما يدريك الله تبارك وتعالى is talking to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم وما يدريك and who told you and how do you know and whom do you think yourself وما يدريك لعله يزكى أو يذكر maybe when you teach him something he will make use of it
那先知阿拉就跟先知穆罕默德说呢 你怎么会知道那你以为你是谁也许你跟这个盲人教他的话也许他会学到很好的东西
أما من استغنى those rich people فأنت له تصدى this rich person so you sit with him and you spend your time and you talk to him
那个有钱有地位的人那你就是花你的时间坐下来跟他讲话吗
وما عليك ألا يزكى أو يذكى فتنفعه الذكرى and who told you that if you talk to him he will become Muslim
那谁跟你讲说你只要跟他讲话就成为穆斯林
see in another ayahAllah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala talking to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't hide it. The proof that he didn't hide it is there is in Quran and we read it every day.
那还有另外一节呢，也是阿拉有跟先知穆罕默德讲，然后呢，先知穆罕默德他也没有把它藏起来，他还是就是把它公告出来，我们大家都读得到。
Listen to this. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says talking to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ما من حسابهم عليك من شيء وما من حسابك عليهم من شيء فتطردهم فتكون من الخاسرين.It is not you who will say if they are winners or losers, and not they who will say if you are winners or losers. If you kick them out only because you think that they are losers, then you are the loser.
那阿拉跟先知穆罕默德说，不是你以为他们是胜，就是是成功的人或者失败的人，他们就是成功的人，不是你自己去决定，也不是他们去决定的。那你就把他们赶出去的话，代表就是你讲的是对的。
Another ayah, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala talking to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Quran. It is in Quran forever. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says talking to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَيْسَ لَكَ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ شَيْءٍ أَوْ يَتُوبُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَوْ يُعَذِّبُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ ظَالِمُونَ لَيْسَ لَكَ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ شَيْءٍ If we want to translate it in our language, it is not your business.
那在另外一节经文，阿拉也跟先知穆罕默德说呢，他这句话的意思呢，就是说这个不关你的事，不用管。
If Allah wants to punish them, He will punish them. If Allah wants to forgive them, He will forgive them.
Allah 要惩罚，
那是 your business.
Allah 要惩罚他们 ，Allah 就会惩罚他们。Allah 要奖赏他们，就会他原谅他们，就会原谅他们。这个不关你的事情。
Today, it is all of us our business.
今天呢，反而我们都觉得好，都是我们的事情，我们都要管。
Today, as if we have the deeds, you know, of the land in paradise, we're just giving people.
今天好像我们已经有得到天堂的这个地契一样，然后就是。
And in hell, of course, you know, once there was one person, he went, you know, he found that in the church, this is real story, he found that in the church, they are selling the deeds, you know, they are selling the land in paradise.
就是说有是一个真实的故事，就是有个教堂，他有在卖那个天堂的这个地契。
Yeah, and then of course depends, you know, that this is on the seaside, this is on the mountain, and here, so prices are different.
就是说呢，你是要住在海边还是山上，那个价钱不一样。
And they were making big money.
然后他们还赚很多钱。
Then one person, he went to them.
那有个人就去找他们。
You know, they were three or four crystal fathers, they are doing this business.
大概有大概三四个这个神父和这个牧师在做这件事情。
So he went to them.
然后这个人去找他们。
He said, I want to buy the hell.
他说我要买地狱的地。
They said, what? He said, yeah, I want to buy the hell.
他说什么？他说我要买地狱的土地。
They said, you know, one of them, he said, but we don't, you know, so the second one is just, you know, talking. He said, okay, we will arrange.The agreement for selling you the hell.
他说好了，另外一个就敲他一下，就说好，我会帮你去找到这个买卖的这个契约。
That one he wanted to tell him that we don't sell hell, we are only selling paradise. But then the second priest he found that this is good business. He said, okay, we will sell you the hell.
第一个人本来是要跟他说呢，我们没有在卖地狱的。不过第二个想说这是不做生意，他说哟哟，等一下我会卖给你。
Tomorrow we'll tell you how much is it.
那明天我跟你讲多少钱。
Then next day he went to them, then they told him that it is $10 million.
那就隔天呢，他就来了，他就跟他说呢，这是$10,000,000.
He said, okay, fine. He paid $10 million and he bought the hell.
他就买了$10,000,000，然后呢，就是买了，花了$10,000,000，然后买了这个地狱。
And then he announced in the church that no need to buy paradise anymore. I bought the hell, so none of you would go to hell.
他就隔天他就去那个教堂跟大家就公告，就说呢，哎，你们不用再去买那个天堂的土地的这个契约了，因为那个地狱的土地全部都被我买走，所以你们没有地方了，就不会下地狱了。
So people stop buying paradise.
所以大家就不会再去买这个跟他买这个天堂的土地了。
So then those three priests, you know, they went to him to negotiate with him.
然后这三个这个牧师呢，就跑去跟这个人商量。
So then he sold the hell to them again, $100 million.
然后呢，他就用$1,000,000就卖给他们。
So he did good business with them.
所以他就可能赚了很多钱。
So unfortunately today, many of us think that we have access, you know, that we control hell and paradise.
就现在好像很多人都觉得好像自己已经有这个有特殊的管道哦，可以去掌管天堂一样。
So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he gave the authority to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.To spread this, to give those, you know, benefits, those reward income, to give. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave it to all of them equally.
哦，反正就是在一平化的限制，就是把就是每个人平均分配。
But the thing that was not really very equal, but they were so happy with it. Do you know what is it?
那有件事情虽然不是很公平，不过大家都很高兴。
Who was the first three who started the battle?
是哪三个开始战的？
Remember? One uncle, two cousins.
就是先是爸爸的。
Hamza, Hudhayfa and Ali.
一个叔父跟两个堂弟。
Remember? Hudhayfa passed away.
Hudhayfa 死掉了。
Hamza and Ali didn't pass away.
那 Hamza 跟 Ali 还活着。
And they didn't take anything.
他们一毛钱也没拿。
See the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, his relatives, when it is war, when it is dangerous, his relatives, they are the first. When it is rewarding an income, they don't take.
就是当要上战场的时候呢，先知都第一个推他的亲人上去。然后当有这个奖赏的时候呢，他亲人一毛钱都没有拿。
And of course they are happy, they agree with it.
但是呢，其实他们都非常的高兴，他们对这样的，就是他们很高兴他这样做。
The Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, according to Quran,According to Quran, the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ should take 20%.
那根据古兰经来讲的话呢，规定的话，先知穆罕默德可以拿到20%。
From any income, this is in Quran. From any income.
在古兰经里面有讲，就是任何的收入，先知都可以拿20%。
One fifth. So it is 20 or 25. 20%.
就是五分之一。
But the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ never take.
但先知穆罕默德他从来都没有拿。
Because the same. Why to take?As long as I'm eating, drinking, sleeping, and one day I'm leaving, then why to take?
就反正我有在吃，有在喝，有在睡觉。那有一天我要离开这个世界，那干嘛就多拿这些东西？
Do we have this idea today?
我们有没有这样的一个想法？
No. Today, actually, we are ready to die for some money, and then we get this money, we die and then we don't take it with us.
所以今天呢，我们会为了一些钱而不惜，就是不惜一切代价去得到一些钱，但是我们一死了之后，这些钱一毛钱带不走。
So things remains, things return back to a normal way between Muslims in Medina, and they became rich, they became powerful, and other tribes.They became so nervous and worried that 300 people they could attack and defeat 1,000. Then we have to be careful of those people.
那麦地那居民他们就重新回到原本平静的生活，而且他们多增加很多的财富，他们就丰衣足食，那越来越壮大。那么周遭的一些外族的人，他们就开始忐忑不安，他想说他们300多个人可以打败1,000多个人，那这样子他们就开始害怕。
But who was living there in Medina?Jewish, they were living there. And the Prophet Muhammad, remember yesterday we said the Prophet Muhammad, he already made agreement with them. But Jewish, they never know the meaning of agreements. Since ever and forever, they never know the meaning of agreements. And this is one of the things that today Muslims, they don't understand it.
这也是今天的穆斯林他不了解的。
They say we have to sit and negotiate for peace.
我们要坐下来跟他们商量，来协商，来和平谈判。
We have to sit and discuss. This is yours, this is ours, and we live together, and we are happy, and we are okay.
就是说我们坐下来好好的谈，这边是归你们的，这边归我们的，但我们互相的不要井水不犯河水。
You forget for us.
那我忘记古兰经里面告诉我们。
Allah says in Quran in chapter 2, وَلَنْ تَرْضَى عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَا النَّصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ. This is Quran. لَنْ, what is the meaning of لَنْ? لَنْ is a negative for future.
那阿拉在古兰经第二章里面有讲，他用لَنْ 这个词的话呢，它是未来的否定词。
Future. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, when he says something in the future, so it is forever.
那阿拉讲说，在未来的事情的话呢，就表示是永远。
لن ترضى عن اليهود ولا النصارى. اليهود is Jewish, Nasara is Christians.
犹太人跟基督教徒。
Jewish and Christians, لن ترضى عنك. They will never ever be satisfied with you.
犹太人跟基督徒绝对永远不会跟你们好好的相处。
With you who?
你们是谁？
Muhammad and your people, me too.
Muhammad and his 国族，也就是我们穆斯林。
Hatta until tattabi'a millatahum, until you become one of them.
直到说你变成他们其中一份子，否则他们不会放过你们。
This is Quran.
This is Quran.
If Allah Tabaraka wa Taala is saying no need to negotiate with them, they will not listen. No need to sit with them because the only way to satisfy them is to tell them, okay, I'm not Muslim anymore. I am Jewish.They want to sit with them.
Allah 在古兰经里面都讲很清楚了，说你不用跟他们坐下来谈，因为呢，他们唯一会接受的就是只有你说我不是穆斯林，他才会真正的接受你。那我们都已经阿拉都讲那么清楚了，为什么还是执意说要去跟他们要去和谈什么的
？But of course, this is because we are far away from Islam.
当然，就是因为大家都很离伊斯兰非常的遥远。
So in Medina at that time, there were Jewish, and there was another group, which was even more dangerous than Jewish.
那在麦地那那边有一群人是犹太人，那有一群人是比犹太人更危险的人。
What is that group? The group of hypocrites.
就是伪信者。
Do you know how many hypocrites in Medina that time?
你知道麦地那那边有多少伪信者吗？
According to the Sahaba, according to the history, there were 300 male hypocrites, 70 female hypocrites.
那就是有300个男生的伪信者，有70个女生的伪信者，这是他们这些先知的弟子他们所讲的。
They kept on being killed and died, and some of them they changed into good Muslims and so on. But Allah Tabaraka wa Taala, He sent Jibreel once to tell the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam about 17 hypocrites. They will die hypocrites.
那就是他们有一些人呢，就是。伪信者啊，有些人就死掉了。那有些人后来就变成好的穆斯林了。不过后来呢，阿拉派遣加百列天使去跟先知穆罕默德说，有17个人，他们一直到死都不会改变，一直到死都会是伪信者。
Those 17 hypocrites, the Prophet Muhammad SAW, he told the names of those 17 hypocrites to one of his companions only.
那先知为了把这十七个人的名单呢，只有告诉他其中的一个弟子而已。
And he told him, "This is a secret; no one should know."
他就跟他的弟子说，这是一个秘密，不要跟任何人讲。
Imagine 17 hypocrites. Imagine hypocrite means what? إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ كَانُوا فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. Hypocrites, they are in the deepest place in hell. Means under the disbelievers.
那违信者呢？阿拉有讲，他们是在最底层的一个地狱。那也就是说呢，他们是在那个不信者的不信道的更下面。
We said before, hypocrite is more dangerous than the kafir, than the disbeliever.
我们之前有讲过，这个伪信者呢，比不信道的人更危险。
Remember, we said this before. We have two cups of water, two glasses of water.
我们有两杯水。
Our two glasses.
好，有两个杯子。
One has water.
一杯里面是白开水。
Three or four drops of poison inside this water.
这个白开水里面，我给它点了三四滴的毒药。
And one is full of poison.
那另外一杯的杯子里面装的是完完全全的毒药。
Which one is more dangerous?
哪一杯比较危险
？The water with poison or the poison?
就是说毒药本身呢，还是白开水有毒药的白开水
？The water with poison is more dangerous.
就是有毒药的白开水比较危险。
Why?
为什么呢
？Because the one with poison, I know it. I'm not touching.
因为既然是毒药，我就知道它是毒药，我就不会去喝它了。
I will be away from it totally.Poison. I know what is this.
我会远远的跟他保持距离，不要去碰他。
But this one is water.
但是这杯是白开水啊。
It's not easy to know that it is poison.
那不太容易就可以知道里面有三四滴的毒药。
So I might just take it and drink it.
最有可能就直接把它拿来喝了。
See, this poisoned water is the hypocrite.
这个白开水有毒药的白开水呢，就是伪信者。
So this is why the hypocrite is more dangerous than the disbeliever. Why? Because the hypocrite, he sits with you. He talks to you. You say Muhammad, he says Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
就说那个伪信者呢，他就是比较危险的，因为他都跟我们生活在一起啊。然后你讲先知穆罕默德名字的时候，他就会念这个为他的安详。
And then what is inside is that he Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, the leader of the hypocrites.
就是 Abdullah 这个人呢，他是伪信者的首领。
Why he was the leader of the hypocrites? Do you know why?
为什么他是伪信者的首领呢
？The same day, the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم arrived to Medina. The same day, it was the day to celebrate that Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul will become the leader of Medina.
就是说，刚到先知穆罕默德他刚抵达麦地那的这一天呢，也是刚好这个 Abdullah 呢，他接任就是麦地那的首领的这一天。
The same day.
同一天。
When the Prophet Muhammad came, then all of them they were busy with him, and they totally left Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul.
那就当先知穆罕默德抵达麦地那，大家都迎接他啊，每个都忘记说今天是他的就职典礼。
And he could see that he cannot bring people back to him.
那他就可以看到说，还有就职典礼都没有一个人来。
So what he did?
现在怎么办呢
？He went with them to celebrate. He went with them to congratulate the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
所以他就加入他们去庆祝先知穆罕默德来临。
And he showed that he is Muslim.
然后他就让他们看到说，哎，我就是穆斯林。
And he was in a hidden way, he was making the trouble between Muslims.
然后他都是私底下，就是偷偷的，就是在穆斯林之间制造一些问题。
Of course, today, if Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, if he comes today, he will complain. That's why we call him the leader of hypocrites. He will be a very small student in front of some of the people here.
那如果说 Abdullah 今天来到我们这个清真寺的话呢，他可能会抱怨说：“你怎么说我是伪信者的首领呢？”因为在清真寺里面，很多人呢都比他还厉害。
Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, five times a day he prayed behind the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, including Fajr.
那 Abdullah 呢，他每次五拜呢，他都在先知穆罕默德的正后方里，包括城里也是。
Whenever the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم sit in the masjid and talk, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul is there, sitting and listen.
只要先知穆罕默德要演讲，他马上过来，坐在他最前面。
So it is not to sit and listen. It depends. You are listening using your ears, or you are listening using your heart.
那重点是说，不是你坐在那边听，是听的是耳朵听进去就当做耳边风呢，还是你心里面真正有在去感受
？Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, when he was sitting, he was listening. He was using only his ears to listen.
那 Abdullah 呢？他听的，他坐在那边听的，只是左耳进右耳出。
should pray for my janaza.
而且他说呢，我的这个病理一定要请先生们的帮我理。
See, people prayed after that.
就他死了之后还要当求信。
And of course, Umar ibn al-Khattab was so angry.
那欧玛很生气。
Then the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he looked at Umar ibn al-Khattab. He said, "Ya Umar, what will my teacher tell Abdullah?"
那先生就跟欧玛说呢，我的这个衬衫呢，能够给他带来多少帮助
？And the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he prayed the janaza.For Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul.
那先生问的也帮这个 Abdullah 这个人理他的病。
And listen to this carefully in 1 minute. Some people today, they say that you must pray the janazah for anyone who say La ilaha illallah, because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed the janazah over Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul.
今天有些人就讲说呢，只要这个人他讲 La ilaha illallah 的话，那你就一定要帮他理这个病。
Then we say, wait, we are not saying that the Prophet Muhammad didn't pray the janazah for Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. We are not saying this. He did. He prayed. This is confirmed in hadith and in sirah. This is confirmed.
就说木兰这个事情是肯定的，先知穆罕默德的确是为这个违信者的首领理他的这个丧礼这个病理。
But when we are studying Islam, we need to study Islam with.Or in details.
但是我们要去研究伊斯兰的话，我们要研究他们的细节。
So when we study Islam, we will know that after this, when the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم did this, after this, Allah تبارك وتعالى revealed Quran, and He said, "ولا تصلي على أحد منهم مات أبدا," and never pray for any one of those hypocrites die. Never make dua for them. Never ask Allah to forgive them.And never pray the janazah over them.
但是在这件事情结束，这个病理结束之后呢，阿拉将士的古兰经，他讲说呢，绝对不要为那一些违信者，为他们礼拜，不要为他们做读啊，
And no supplicate that no, don't ask Allah to forgive them.
不要请求阿拉来赦免他们，然后不要去为他们做读啊，那也不要为他们理病理。
And in another ayah, Allah Tabaraka wa Taala says, "In the stafir nahum." أولاد استغفرت لهم أم لم تستغفر لهم لن يغفر الله لهم no matter you ask me to forgive them or you don't ask me to forgive them I will not forgive them
那在另外一节经文阿拉讲说不管你有没有请求我去饶恕他们我都不会去饶恕他们
and for the disbelievers Allah تبارك وتعالى said for the disbelievers إن تستغفر لهم أو لا تستغفر لهمأستغفرت لهم أو لا تستغفر لهم إن تستغفر لهم 70 times فلن يغفر الله لهم No matter you ask for forgiveness or you don't ask for forgiveness If you ask for forgiveness 70 times I will not forgive them
但对不信道的人呢阿拉太古兰经讲述呢不管你要不要去上面为他们跟我求饶就算你求饶了70次我还是不会原谅他们
And to understand the Prophet Muhammad said he said WallahiI swear by Allah, if I know that if I ask Allah to forgive them 71 times, He will accept, I will do, but I know He will not accept. 70 is not a number. 70 is to know. No matter how much, it is useless.
先生默默的也说了，我跟阿拉发誓，就是说阿拉虽然讲70次，那如果说我就算跟阿拉求了71次，阿拉还是不会原谅他，因为重点，这个70并不是一个数字，而是代表说不管多少次的意思。
Jewish.With the support of this bill, with the support of hypocrites, they prayed the agreement between them and Muslims, and there was a fight, and some other things happened, and some people were killed, and some other new things happened in Medina because of this, because of breaking of this agreement. We will know it tomorrow, inshallah.
就是这些犹太人呢，跟那一些违信者呢，他们就联合起来，就把他们之前跟先知穆罕默德、跟穆斯林所签的这个协定，把它毁约了。然后他们就是开始制造一些麻烦，然后开始就是双方就有一些争执、一些争斗，然后就造成了一些伤亡。那这个明天我们会讲。
我说你老马的是伊斯兰穆罕默德瓦的爱的，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，我说你，